we really designed this game to help people understand how disease like COVID-19 can transmit through a population. COVID Crush is a toy model. It's a game that I created along with my colleague at the Applied Population Lab, Caitlin Borbo. I thought it would be useful for people to have something that they could interact with and really see how effective social distancing can be and how it works. What we have is a population represented by dots. There are 1,000 dots and they represent individual people. As soon as one dot goes from incubating to sick, I'm going to turn on social distancing and we'll see what happens then. So I'm watching that sick counter and it got to one. And what happens is all the dots go to their home and they stay there until you release social distancing. And you can see that within each household, there's really high exposure within the household. So quite a few more dots still get sick, but it's limited. These other dots that are also staying at home are protected. And so the outbreak is much more limited and you'll end up having something like 12 to 15% of the population infected. And another thing that's interesting to try here is that we can set up the simulation so that we lock everybody down, do the safer at home order as soon as the infection is detected. But then when the case counts, the number of sick people start to go down, we release social distancing. And this, I think, is instructive for those states that are ready to come out of safer at home as soon as they've crossed the so-called peak. We can see when we release social distancing, as soon as the case counts start to go down, they just immediately go back up. That's actually the highest risk moment to release social distancing in terms of continuing the spread of the disease. We're going to end up with probably almost every dot infected after 4 weeks of simulated time. It's not realistic to say every single person stays home. We don't live in a bubble and we need some people to still go about their business and drive the buses, collect the trash, work at grocery stores. And of course, we need doctors and nurses to still be able to go to work. So the dots move at random. And that is also not very realistic. None of us really moves at random. We move through space in patterns. You know, for example, I wake up at the same address most mornings and interact with the people in my household. Under normal circumstances, I go to work and I interact with the same set of people at work every day. You can look at the effect of that to some extent in the simulation by changing this movement mode from random to visit neighbors. And what this does is it allows each of the dots to visit their 5 nearest neighbors. And I think it's very interesting. This turns out to be the most effective way to allow the virus to spread through the whole population. And that's because by creating those small world networks, you've really guaranteed every dot or nearly every dot has contact with every other dot through a short number of connections. And so as we see this play out, even with a very small percent of people breaking the social distancing order and having turned on social distancing really early, we'll still get almost everyone infected. You know, it's a highly simplistic version of what happens in reality, but I think it can teach us something about how the real world works, even though the real world is considerably more complex. To play COVID Crush, you can go to the APL website at apl.wisc.edu/COVID.